Hello and welcome back to my channel. So, this video is about pansies. Of course, you need to draw and do the sketch before you are going to paint it. I personally wouldn't be able to paint that flower without that sketch.
Here, wiggle your pencil a little bit so it will look like more realistic, more nicer. And start from the middle of the, like, under and middle of the petal you just draw. And then you can draw the other petal. And do the same with the other two. And this last petal is on those two petals. Above those. And the first was under those two petals. So, tip for the leaf. Imagine you are drawing some heart shape, but then end it in the middle of the heart, and then do the same thing and go how up you want, and you're just doing the same thing again, and you are having that leaf. I will tell those specific names on description. And so yeah, red, blue and brown. And then you just want to paint that petal with only water. And here you can see I use the light so I can see where is already some water and where it's not. And don't be too afraid if you're having this thick and rough paper. You should use water enough and tap that color in, so you're just tapping it on those edges and wherever you want, and draw some lines from the bottom. And here you are going to do the same thing.
And I wanted to tell you very quickly that I have this mini guide where you can see what mistakes you probably are doing with watercolors if you are a beginner. But yeah. Those are 5 tips I will give you for free, and the link is on my description box, and you will also receive some other tips I will give you for free. And I'm also planning to make some course in the near future. Yeah, if you're interested about some watercolor course, then let me know.
I meant watercolor course, not curse. And here I'm tapping also that yellow color in this time, but yeah, it looks pretty difficult when I'm painting that. I don't know if it affects that I'm filming, but you can do it easily with just maybe a few brush strokes. Yeah, and there you saw that I painted a little bit more on the petal too, because it's on the real pansy too. Yeah, I just took some color off too, so there be a little bit white on the middle. And these are just very regular brush strokes, what I'm doing there. I painted with that same color, but I mixed more of that, and it's not so light, so use less water. And I also tapped with paper towel to get rid of some color, because it was too dark, I think. And that's the same color again, doing those, not veins, but some details on that flower. So use very like light hand when you are painting those. And maybe you're wondering, what is that sharp thing? Well, it's I don't know what it's called in English, but it's very sharp, so I'm scrapping that color and, well, also that paper off. So I got some white areas on that flower because I did a mistake, because I didn't leave those when I was painting. So here we are. And there I used the same technique with this stem. So I painted it with only water and then tapped some green color on there. And yeah. And then I'm adding more color to get some like darker spaces or darker spots on the stem. And here on the leaf I'm using wet on wet technique too, as you can see. And I filmed or I edited that first leaf off because I didn't use enough of water, so it wouldn't look so great. It didn't look so great. So here you are seeing I'm using quite a lot of water because this is thick and rough paper. And yeah, I'm tapping that color on that leaf here and there. Depends how you want it, but I'm doing it this way. I have no idea if you could hear, but my dog was literally cleaning herself. So I don't know if you can hear some leaking noises. There, I couldn't hear it but when I listened this audio, but yeah. I painted these veins very easy way, so some very kinda straight lines only. And don't add too much water if you want this darker green color. And I did some strokes on the stem too, but you have to do them if you don't want. And we are done. I hope this was helpful for you and not too difficult. And don't forget to click the link on my description box to have those free tips what you should avoid when painting watercolor flowers. See you! And thank you for being here. Bye bye!